Alright, so here we go with BattleBox again. This is Multani versus Sidhar Kanda. So, I guess Multani first, because this is polarizing. In BattleBox, you normally start off with four cards in hand, and his hand modifier is -3. So I'll start off with one card. I know that's bad, but I really just want to get the experience of it. When else am I going to be able to try that? Can't mulligan. You actually can't mulligan. And then Sidhar Kanda also deprives him of a card, but gain 12 life, and he gets 3 mana for +3/+3, whenever he feels like it. Okay. 7. Maybe you'll win the die roll this time. They love me, man. They're loaded in my favor. Alright, there we go. 1 card.
3 cards.
Can I keep this? Oh my god. And it's also a terrible card to start off with.
Well,
no, it's fine. It's fine. Can't really.
Down to 0. No. And you mulligan, and oh, it's a more expensive card.
Yeah.
You know.
I guess mulligan, and then you look at the scry. No, that's not. That sounds terrible. All right, so I'll be on the play then. I will play a Selesnya Guildgate and pass the turn.
Sure, you don't want to draw with a 1 card hand.
Do I get to draw on the play?
No. I mean, if you went second, if you chose.
I mean, I would. Had I not seen this, I still would have wanted. No, that's fine. That's fine. I see what you're saying. Had I not seen my card, I probably should have wanted to, since I start at 1. But I'm also a really aggro character.
I have no idea what's correct.
We'll play a swamp and play a cartel aristocrat. Pass the turn.
A 3-2, soon to be 4-2, cartel aristocrat.
Yep. Aristocrat, get there. Oh, Multani.
Selesnya Guildgate. Pass turn.
Alright, swing 4. And then play a. There's not a blue red. Oh well. I think that we'll choose. A Dimir Guildgate. Pass the turn.
Okay.
I can see how in formats where you start with a lot more cards in hand, Multani would get out of hand really quickly. Imagine if we started with 7 cards, and in Multani's case 4, and I was playing Infect.
Yeah.
That would be awful. Oh,
then you'd have to play lands, too.
You would have to play lands, too, that's true. Still, land, turn 1, Glistener Elf, Invigorate, Berserk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, sure, yeah.
Not
if
even
if you get to choose, if you get to choose the deck you're playing, you can abuse. Well, most of them. Maybe not Sidhar. It'd be pretty hard to abuse.
That's true.
Unless you had infinite mana.
I guess starting with 12 extra life is kind of nice for certain matches.
Oh, that's true. That's true.
Maybe it's a mid-range thing.
Or you could have a bunch of value creatures that, you know, you just grind.
Yeah. I'll turn my Wall of Omens into a 3/7. Yeah.
Or a bunch of mana dorks, maybe. And
ooh.
Play elves? I don't know.
Birds of Paradise all day. Yeah, block with it and then tap it. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Play Fiend Hunter.
Rip. Actually. Yeah, so if I respond to it by killing the Fiend Hunter, I lose the Aristocrat for good, because that's not Banisher Priest.
Right. You'd have to counter it.
Well, that sucks. Oh, well.
You can kill it now.
I can kill it now, except I can't, because of what I have in my hand.
Okay, your turn.
Normally, yes. Not this time, though. Oh, or that could happen, I guess. Flame Tongue Kavu.
Okay.
I guess that's a thing.
Definitely a thing.
And then pass turn.
Untap. Draw. Grazing Glade Heart.
Okay, Landfall.
Forest.
Gain two, fair enough.
Birds.
Birds!
Pass turn.
Alright, alright. Okie dokie. Okay. How about play a forest, prophetic bolt, four damage to the blade heart, and then look at the top four, so it'll replace itself to keep the power that high. Ooh. Like all of these. But alas. Yeah. I think we need it to be you. We do. Make sure they're turned the right way. Alright, we're good. And then, rawr.
How much is that?
5, 13. Excuse me, 12. I can't count.
12 damage.
I can't count. Pass turn. I'm good at this game. Yay. What have I taken damage from? The Fiend Hunter? And that's it? No. I don't think I've taken damage yet, have I?
No.
Okay. Then I just must have hit that incorrectly, because I start at minus two.
Ember Hauler.
Yep. Yeah, this only improves the power.
Rule Guild Gate.
Mm-hmm.
Pass turn.
How about we go to beginning of combat?
Sure.
Yeah.
Block. Sacrifice. 1 damage. Or, sorry, 2 damage.
Yeah, I gotcha. How about we repeal that? So I'll bounce it back to hand and draw a card.
I'll play negate.
Okay, that'll do it. So, Aristocrat be gone. Next, we'll play a Porcelain Legionnaire, and I'll lose two.
Okay, that seems good with your character's power.
Yeah. And then Timber Gorge, lots of green, all of the green, and pass turn.
Untap. Draw. Play Wing Splicer.
Uh-oh.
Golem. 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 then a Woolly Thoctar.
A Woolly Thoctar. Yep. That's a 5/4. Yep. All right, that's turn.
Have I played I think I must have played a land because you're ahead on land, so yeah, your turn.
Thoctar, Ogar! I like this. Let's see. Actually, I think we'll do this now. Flames of the Firebrand, 1/1. You.
Okay.
Then blip. Destroy target artifact. Swing 4.
We'll take 4.
All right. Lucky number 13, main 2. Zorya's Guildgate. Pass turn.
Draw. Swing for 5.
There's no way that this doesn't bite me in the butt, I'm sure. Flametongue Kavu will block and will trade.
Okay. Appetite for Brands.
Makes me discard a card?
If it's 4 or more.
It is not. It's a prey upon. That was actually my starting card. That's why I was complaining. Doesn't really work on its own.
We'll play Timely Horde Mate.
Ooh.
Get back Ember Hauler and then sacrifice it and kill the Porcelain Legionnaire.
Yep. That's a thing. Back to basics.
The Mirror Guild Gate.
Ooh. Okay. That's a thing, I suppose. We'll say Cradle Guard.
Okay.
Rakdos Guildgate. I mean, I guess I could now, but I'm a bigger creature. I don't think I have to worry about that. So, pass turn. Trample, echo, but no haste.
Back to stretching. I'm hellbent, so go for it.
Uh-oh.
Flex drop from darkness.
We each mill two, and then I res a creature.
Okay. Rapid hybridization and stunted growth. So no more creatures. You have a Flame Tongue Kavu.
The Flame Tongue Kavu.
Yeah.
And I'll kill your Cradle Guard.
I guess in response, I'll... Since I'm going to lose it regardless, I'll prey upon...
But that's a sorcery.
It is a sorcery! That's why I should have done it earlier. I did not remember that. Bye-bye, Cradle Guard.
And then I'll attack for three.
Okay. I'll take three.
Also, I can buff.
Yep. Good to know. Oh, you're one mana shy for the buff. It's three.
I'm not right now. Also, I will play a land.
Fair enough. Right on time, Devoted Druid. Pass turn. Yeah, that's why I should have done that. Today I learned. RTFC.
Swings.
Alright, take it, go down to six. Unless we're killing me.
Buff.
Yeah, we're killing me. Okay. Alright, that's game. So you just do it twice and we're done. We're done here. Oh my goodness. So if I had played that correctly, played the Prey Upon so that they would trade, I'd be down three mana. Then I play the Devoted Druid, next turn Gurmog Angler. Basket, yeah, okay. So I might have survived that. Maybe. If I had done that correctly. I would like to be... That's how this works. I might actually just want the tempo and just hope that this is a card I can use. But maybe that's not right. When you start with so few cards, maybe it isn't. I think I will actually be on the play, though.
Okay.
It's one of the cards we talked about earlier. One of the 10 or so, my friend.
All right,
let's start off with a... Dimir Guildgate, and pass the turn.
I will also start off with the Dimir Guildgate, and pass the turn.
Vampire Lacerator.
Oh, there you go.
And then I am down to put me to 18, for now, of course. And then, say, Selesnya Guildgate, colors, pass turn. Oh, Lacerator.
Rakdos Guildgate. Go ahead.
Take one. I don't think I'll have you below 10.
Yeah.
Or at 10 or below for some time. But we will swing for 4.
Okay. Take it.
Blip, 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 blip. How about... Needs to be one of the red ones. Say, Timber Gorge. And then pass turn.
Ooh. Liliana Spectre?
makes me discard a card. Yeah. Oh, well, okay then. I don't want to get rid of either of these, but that's pretty big, man. That is pretty big. How about... Plasm Capture. One more turn, man. One more turn.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, you were setting it up, too.
I was.
That would have been really good.
And that's turn?
Yeah.
I figure since I have so few cards in hand, even if I get a bunch of mana, I can't do much about it.
That's true. I guess depending what the other card is, but...
Yeah.
It could enable you to play something crazy early.
Mm-hmm. I guess I'll swing four.
I'll block.
Yep, we'll trade.
Yeah, I feel like this matchup is me trading and then getting like the default card advantage is
yep.
really good.
Azorius into, say, I don't know, Voidstalker.
Okay.
Now you see it, now you're gone. Pass turn.
Draw.
I have my own tier list for the various guilds. Rakdos is my least favorite, then Gruul, and all the way up until Selesnya. So.
Play Azorius Guild Gate. Pass turn.
Alright. If I sort them by preference.
Upkeep. I'm gonna put Pestermite and tap your Gruul Guild Gate.
In response. I mean, either I trade or we shuffle them.
Yeah. One way you're paying three mana.
Yep. I think that's okay. I'll make it work. Let's shuffle them in.
Okay. I think I might take out Woodstalker just for the shuffling, just for shuffling reasons.
I can see that. Just makes it take a little bit longer. Yeah. It's not a bad card.
And sometimes these decks are huge. So it's hard to shuffle them.
I like that it can trade from a distance, but maybe there's a better way to do that. Like a Vortex Elemental, but that still requires shuffling, actually. I don't know. Something that, like a Royal Spout, puts it on top and has Awaken. Oh, what are we doing? This is Battle Box. Anyway, I'll draw. Obviously not something I'm going to actually be able to use, so get the last guild gate out, and pass turn.
Okay. Ominous Spring.
Draw a card. There you go, bro.
Ooh, did not see that coming. Okay. I'll play Selesnya Guildgate. Pass turn.
Alright. Sort again by order. You'd think I'd prefer Gruul over Dimir, but Gruul just seems too dumb for me to appreciate it. Oh, that's maybe not great. We'll make it work, I guess. Swamp?
Okay.
Everything but one for a Cloud Goat Ranger.
Oh, that's the Multani card. That's yep. the payoff.
And then once we have our Kithkin, we'll also play a Jackal Pop. That's not so hot, but I'll take it. It's a good card. And then...
You don't have to be nice.
Pass turn.
It's not a very good card.
No. I mean, it's all standard play for a reason, but... That was because Goblin Guide and Monastery Swift Spear et al. Maybe weren't. Yeah, pass turn.
Okay. Draw.
Also, you had to have that Kithkin art.
Mmm. Let's do its nose.
Okay. Yeah. Evolution.
Cryptoplasm. Evolve.
The beginning of your upkeep, have it become a copy of another target creature. Okay. Well, fair enough, I suppose.
Cruel Guildgate. Pass turn.
Draw that card and you like it.
Back in the game, Jay.
I'd like to think so. How about Rar?
Yeah, seems good. What do they have? Plus two, plus O?
Plus two, plus O, exactly. So we're looking at 12, 17.
I think I'll trade the Shaman of Spring for the Jackal Pup.
Alright. I'll take a 2 off of that. 2 damage to it. Okay. And then that means that you'll end up taking... Wait a minute, that's a 2-1, not a 1-1. These are 1-1s, making them 3-1s in this.
Mm-hmm.
That was... So it's 4 that was blocked. So it's not that...
3, 6, 9...
14, then.
14. Okay. Take
right.
14.
Let's go to 14 all. In 2... How about Forest Geico Gecko, Basking Root Walla?
I'm a root walla, not a gecko.
That's right. There's the play that uses my mana most efficiently, and then there's the play that's more fun. Let's do the one that's more fun. Let's get back all 2 of my creatures from the graveyard.
Nice. And dump them.
And then dump them.
Sweet. Hellbent.
Hellbent in Multani.
Lots of creatures.
Lots. Pass turn.
Even with one card in hand, that is pretty insane.
You're not wrong.
Draw. Okay. I mean, I forgot the cryptoplasm trigger.
You can go back and do that.
I was gonna make it experiment one.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. That does turn it to a 1-1, though, because it doesn't have any counters on it.
Mm-hmm. But the counters will stay.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Let's see.
The first morning after acquiring her familiar, the wizard awoke with flea bites and... Is it mange? Mange? M-A-N-G-E?
Mange? Lay of Sky Knight.
Okay, detain.
Detain Cloud Goat Ranger.
Seems good. I'll do this
evolve
to demonstrate that.
And evolve.
Yep. Uh-oh.
Etched Oracle.
Okay. Yeah, that's a blue, red, black, green, or white. Then remove 4, draw 3 cards. Okay.
Then I'll pass turn.
You can't do anything. Untap it all. Oh!
Uh-oh.
No, not that this is necessarily good, it's just not something I expected to be in here. That's all.
Well, I can't wait to see what it is.
By the way, I take 1 off the Lacerator. They're not really big enough. I think it might be smarter for me to wait, oddly enough. And just when it enters the battlefield, so no more of that. The Oracle's about to draw you three cards. What I'd do for something like that. Do I wait? So if I don't, the maximum I could do here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That's the most I can do, and I'll lose a lot of my board. And you can't attack. I think that I will play a land. Pass the turn.
Sweet. Untap. Upkeep. I'll have Cryptoplasm. I'll have Cryptoplasm become Cloud Goat Ranger.
Fair enough. 3-3. I mean, 5-5.
Draw. Oh, wow. Let's play Island. Black blue for Dimir Guildmage.
This is the mill one, right?
No, it makes you discard.
Oh, it's the newer one that mills. Or that deals with milling. So draw a card, discard a card. Oh, that seems good against me.
I think it is. I think it is. Is that a sorcery?
Even if it's not, I think you still have to do it, right? Well, I don't know what else is in your hand.
Yeah, I think I'll make you discard.
Alright, it is a Haunted Fingraff.
Oh, okay.
So I just thought that was curious that there were lands in the battle box.
Yeah. There's only that one so far.
Okay.
But I think it's good, because, like, 11 lands is an advantage. It's another untapped land.
Fair enough.
And it turns into a creature.
Yep.
I was going to have, like, a whole theme of, like, land and resurrection and stuff. Land resurrection. But, I'll pass turn for now.
All right. I'll, take one from Lacerator. Let's see.
Swing with the team. Okay. Block.
So, Ranger and Sky Knight?
Block the...
A Kithkin?
Okay. I'll block the... Jackal Pup. And
we'll just sort them this way for now.
I'll block here and here.
Okay.
And I'll block
the Lacerator with Cryptoplasm.
Lacerator and Kithkin here.
Okay. So now that we've gotten that sorted out, so I guess we'll start off with pumping the root walla, make you regenerate it. Or, yeah, probably.
Yeah, regenerate it. That was probably bad block, actually. Let's see. Yeah, I should have put him there. Well, no, that would have... Yeah, I should have put him there. This is a 5-5.
It's weird to remember that he's being, like, thrown around as different things, so I don't blame you, but... anything else I want to do here? Nope, this is good. So, trades?
Trade.
Trades. Still get to keep
well,
it.
He survives.
You had to regenerate it, right?
Mm-hmm. So he's a 2-2, and that's a 3-4.
I don't think regenerate inherently removes it from combat. It just means when it would be destroyed, you don't... It's not...
Well, the thing is, he's a 2-2 by the time he deals damage.
That's true. Okay. Okay. That's fair enough, actually. So, yeah, that's right. That is correct. These two will trade, except I'll take 4 from it, because Jackal Pup.
These two trade.
And Kithkin gets wrecked.
You take 4 from me already?
I did. The Jackal Pup I just took 4 from.
I mean, from me? From those guys? I think we're both at...
Where did I take 4 from that earlier? Oh, no, I haven't dealt you 4 yet. Sorry. I see what you're saying. And then next we will play an island, jungle barrier, 1-2, has to be a green source in here, so green and one other. How about, say, Guildgate, Dimir Charm, and then I'll draw a card. Not quite enough. Okay. Pass turn. What would Cryptoplasm like to become?
Oh yeah, good call. I think he'll stay.
Yep, he's still a ranger. Mr. Ranger, sir.
Draw. Mountain.
7-9. No. Nice. One of the battle mages.
Battle mage. Kickers.
Well, so one of them is destroy target land, and then the other one, when it comes into play, what is that? Return up to 2 non-black creatures to their owner's hands.
So I'll bounce your Kithkins.
All right. Gone, baby, gone.
And I'll destroy...
Wait a minute. Don't you just bounce the jungle barrier and you swing for lethal here?
Oh, is that lethal?
Yeah, I won't... So if you... jungle barrier and anything else, this is still a 3-3 with 2 counters. So that's 9 right here.
Oh, that's true.
And I'm at 8.
Well, those are blockers anyway, right?
Well, they were tapped from the previous attack.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I mean, it... Yeah, it's...
I forgot about that.
That's okay. So let's play it out. Let's say you would have gotten it, but let's play it out then.
Okay.
And then destroy one of my lands.
I'll destroy your Dimir Guildgate.
Rest in peace, buddy. Over here, but I can't get it.
Then I'll pass.
Yeah. I was trying to see if there was a way to beat me this turn. Ooh. Well, okay. Play my mountain. I'm going to jam a Corpsejack Menace and an Aether Mutation, targeting Etched Oracle, and I'll get 4 Saprolings. And I'll just let these be the Saprolings, unless we have the tokens. But here, 4 of them. Ta-da! and I am super tapped out.
Here you go.
And then, thank you. I have to put the Bellsprout on top. That's beautiful. And then I'll pass the turn. Doesn't do much good to just attack with the Geico Gecko.
Draw.
Okay, Geico Rootwalla. And I'm Hellbent too. So they are little. Itty bitty.
Mm-hmm. Hypnotic Siren on Corpse Jack Menace.
I think I know where this is going.
And
now, does that trigger evolve? Did it interplay?
Mm-mm.
I didn't think so. Alright. Oh, by the way, upkeep. You wanted to keep it as a ranger or turn it into a Corpse Jack Menace?
That's too late. I wanted to keep it as a Corpse Jack Menace because that would have been sick.
Yeah, man.
Some
super evolved triggers.
I'll play Disfigure on the Basking Rootwalla.
Can't save it.
Pass turn.
Nope. Nope. Well, I appreciate that they could be two ones now. And it has flying! And the creature has flying! Good God. Okay, pass turn.
Okay. So, upkeep becomes an experiment one.
Uh-oh.
Sorry.
Should it be an experiment one or a corpse jack menace?
So, do you have a way to give counters this turn? If so, you can give quadruple the counters.
Well, I can give etched oracle comes in with counters. Oh, yeah. Shit.
Oh,
definitely
God.
Gonna be a corpse jack menace.
Okay, well, this is about to be silly.
Draw.
Okay, watch the beauty that's about to happen, you two. This is going to be silly. Etched Oracle with four different colors. Comes in with four counters. Now, it isn't sacrifice it. It's remove four counters.
It's doubled, right?
And it's doubled and then doubled again. So quadrupled. So we're at 16 counters on it. And now he can remove that three times, draw nine cards, and he'll still have a 4/4. I hear Grizzlebrand is pretty good, man. That's seven mana for nine cards, and you get a 4/4.
And it evolves. My
and it evolves. It actually evolves it again.
Twice, right? Yeah. It's Corpse Jack Menace. And
so it gains four counters.
Four counters, yeah.
Yeah. So we're at a 6/6. Yep.
We'll attack 4 or 5 flying.
Oh, is that all? I mean, I have to take it. No reach.
And Titan Strength.
Of course. Oh, Titan Strength? Yeah, that's an instant.
+3.
Ta-da! Let's resolve the scry first. Gah! I'm at 0. GG, man. GG.
GG.
Yeah, I thought Multani was going to be bad, but this was actually surprisingly fun. I appreciated it.
Also, yeah, I feel like it came down to luck of the draw, too. If you had gotten Etched Oracle, I mean, like, Etched Oracle into, or, like, if you had played the Cloud Goat Ranger and then gotten, like, a draw 3, you know?
That might have been sick.
Would have been pretty crazy.
Dude. Next draw, Hooting Mandrills. Nope, that does not get the job done. I appreciate it, bro, but not so.